Hello, Goodham fans. This is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the 1-144 high grade Qubeley Papillon from the Goodham Millfeder series. So, it is a heavily remolded version of the high grade Qubeley with a new color scheme and quite a few stickers, some mostly decorative. It's kind of weird the band would go out of its way to make like parts that need stickers. Just to make it look fancy. I don't really like it, but it's just the way it is. All the parts are molded there, so if you don't want the stickers, you can hand paint or mask them and spray paint them on. Same thing with the thief in here, and the eyes, and the forehead camera, back of the head, and that's it. So pretty much everything that's blue is a new piece. I don't know about the back piece. That might be the old one. It looks the same as the old one. But everything else that's blue is pretty much new. And I do like it. Yeah, I definitely like it more than I thought it would. I just wish they hadn't used all the stickers. But other than that, it is a pretty nice looking high grade. So the head goes up and down at the head itself. Can't really rotate because of the way the collar is. But the neck and the torso doesn't go pretty far back. And I guess that's why this can move forward. I don't know. The arms can go forwards and back and rotate. And then the binder pieces on the sides have a double hinge, so you can rotate them out and out here and up and down some and get them up. Because usually this one's out, these are down, so you can have them like that or put them out or whatever. And the arms, they don't rotate below the shoulder. They do go out. And they bend the elbow and rotate at the elbow, so that kind of makes up for the lack of the shoulder joint. Ball jointed wrist. You got the stomach crunch and a swivel at the waist. And actually a new piece of articulation in the hips, because I'm pretty sure in the old high grade, the upper leg is one piece. But here you still have the ball joint. But this part here is a swivel, so you have some hip rotation. And then these can move, which they don't really have to move because they don't move out of the way, really. Because the leg can only go that far out, so it doesn't matter. Knee bends at one joint. And the feet are on a ball joint, and the hinged toe. So it's about the same as the old one with a new hip joint. So that's nice. They actually improve the mold a little bit. So the articulation isn't the best, but it's better than it was. Now, the Qubeley never came with a lot of accessories. It comes with the beams for the beam saber, just one solid piece. And they're basically, like, mounted on there. I think that's what they are, right at the arms. And the gold in the hand's fine. And you also have the back skirt, which has the, well, it's actually more of a, I guess it is a back skirt. And it has little funnels, very tiny, very easy to lose. You get quite a few of those. You get 10 of those. And in the show, it had clear ones coming out of the shoulders, I believe, but you don't get any of those, which, well, they're clear, so. What, you know, whatever. You can say, yeah, they are there. They're invisible. Kind of works. And it comes with a set of open hands and holding hands for the beam sabers. That's what the normal Qubeley had, but the new one comes with an extra set for holding the new, javelin beam rifle thing, which has another sticker on the tip. I'm assuming it can fire beams right here. And you can have it hold it like a beam rifle, because it does have a handle, right, like that. Or just take it apart. And this is how I'm going to display it, like a melee weapon, which is really how it used it. And that is basically it for the accessories. You also get the old-style Gundam Seed action base, which I have a ton of, just the normal black base. It's not a big deal. So if you want to have it on a stand, you can. I have too many of those. But it's nice that it comes with it. So that is about it for the accessories. Not a lot, but it does have one more than it did before, so I guess that is a plus. Oh, and before I show some comparisons, you do get some extra pieces from the old Qubeley, like the back of the feet, which I totally didn't put on and forget about and make the video already and then realize someone said that they were wrong. I didn't do that. That's crazy. That'd be stupid. And you also get, I think, lower arm pieces. Not the entire thing, but most of it. And I think the other inner pieces of the side shoulder parts, like these. But I think that's about it. So let's compare this guy to the wing gun of Venice, which it is a lot bigger. The Qubeley is a pretty big high grade. And also compared to the other two Qubeleys I have, the very nice third-party Qubeley, and the actual high-grade Mark II. And that's a lot of shoulder space, but yeah, it definitely stands out among the different Qubeleys, because, you know, there's white, dark blue, red, and then this weird light blue with red trim. So that is the Qubeley Papillon. I like it more than I thought I would. I like it more than before I built the kit. Let's just say that. Still not a big fan of the colors and the overuse of stickers just to make it decorative. They really could have, cut back on that. But it is nice. A lot of new molded pieces do make it stand out. And it does have a new weapon and even some new articulation. So it is a pretty nice kit. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.